In this video, I'm showing you everything you need to know to start your 8mm film. It's a format that is having a bit of a revival these days. It was used in the 50s and 60s, usually for consumers, and you can still use it nowadays. You can find cheap equipment on eBay. Nobody uses it. In Europe, they are making film in the Czech Republic, and you can develop it in Germany. You can also develop it at home, if you are serious about it. If you are really head-on on this, you can even buy a 8mm editor and a projector. But usually people get this scanned. It can be done in high resolution, so you can edit it in your computer. It's a format that is not cheap or expensive. Roll intro. Hello and welcome to this video. Today we are going for 8mm film. 8mm film is a format that you can use in several ways. You can use it on wedding videos, it is amazing for that. You can use it for music videos. And you can also use it if you are in film school. For film school students, it is amazing because you can get cheap equipment and start your film. Of course, being vintage equipment, you have to be careful with what you buy. Try to have it tested, otherwise it is a shot in the dark. Most people find this stuff from their grandfathers in the attic, so you never know what you are buying. And don't use old film. Just avoid that. If you want to be completely different, you can use 8mm film on a music video, and you are doing something that nobody is doing. Also, on wedding videos, you can also do a very different work by presenting them with a 8mm film, and that will make you stand out from the crowd. Just another thing. Don't forget that these cameras don't use the same thread as the new cameras on the tripods. Be aware. Okay, basically you will need a camera, obviously. If you are buying a 50s, early 60s cameras like these, they are really old, so they have no zoom lenses. They have a turret system where you can choose the type of lens you want. I bought this special lens because it is a reflex lens, as this is the disadvantage of these cameras. They are not reflex, and that means that you are not seeing through the viewfinder exactly the image you are exposing. With this lens, I can see exactly what I am exposing, as it includes a viewfinder. The other small lens is a special one because it is f0.9, so for low light it is unbelievable. The light meter is essential. Without it, you will not be able to expose properly. These cameras are really old, they are spring wound, they have no batteries, and usually the batteries they use are for the exposure meter, and it is unreliable. It is really recommended that you use an external light meter. This particular model is great for film, video, and also photography. And the film. Obviously, without film you cannot do anything. Today, they are manufacturing color and black and white film. Honestly, I prefer black and white as it is more vintage looking, like the cameras I am using to shoot it, and I leave color for Super 8. that's my view about it. In the case you don't know, 8mm is in reality double 8mm. I mean, the roll is 16mm, you use it in the camera and you expose only 8mm, then when you finish one side, you reverse the spools and you expose the other 8mm. So when you send it to develop, they cut it in half. So this 10-meter roll in reality is a 20-meter roll. If you want a big change in the look of your film, try 8mm. Of course, you can also try Super 8, even 16mm, but those are more expensive. Having the film scanned will give you lots of other opportunities. If you are shooting in color, you can always change it. If you are shooting black and white, you can always, for instance, edit your videos and change the contrast. Of course, being a very small image that you expose, do not expect the best quality. It was the film that was used in the 50s and 60s for home movies. If you are really serious about it, think about getting some metal cans and spools to store your film. It is great if you can gather a small team to do a film, even if it is a test film. In my case, I cannot do it at the moment as we are in lockdown and I am also waiting for the good weather. Let's hope it comes soon. So this is it. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, give it a like. Subscribe for more videos like this and leave a line in the comments section if you have something to say or ask. I see you in the next video. Take care.